through his interpreter.
Tributes have been pouring in for Benny Hill, whose saucy seaside humour won him millions of fans.
Get me the city desk. Philip, scoop! 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 Bring the scoop! Your dog's pooped on the carpet again.
As we're talking right now, there'll be somebody in Japan or in the middle of Russia falling about at Benny, pouring the coffee over the old man's head, little old Jack, because he's got it wrong. He was looking at a girl at the time, you know, or whatever. So the sauciness was definitely a big point.
Branded sexist by some, Benny's comedy left others in stitches. But in 1989, Thames Television axed his show after 20 years. Off the screens in Britain, the Benny Hill show was snapped up abroad. The son of a Southampton acrobat became a household name in America. He was mobbed in Greece, adored in Italy, and a hero in Japan. His death has hit the headlines across the world.
Tom Fenton, CBS News.
He's an absolute master of timing. And also, he appeals to every cheap stereotype you can imagine, most of them sexist.
Despite suffering a mild heart attack, Benny Hill was back on form when he left hospital in February. Since then, neighbours at his home in Teddington had been keeping an eye on him. They say he liked his privacy, but he did turn up for parties.
Whenever he came to the do's, he was the Benny Hill that we see on TV again. And I always wondered, well, which is a real Benny? You know, the quiet chap that wants to be alone, or the one that, when he's got people around him, you know, is a great comedian.
Good evening,
the man who could afford a gold-plated Rolls-Royce but preferred to walk has left most of his multi-million pound fortune to two women suffering from cerebral palsy. They became his most devoted fans.
All of you, believers and sceptics alike.